أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العلي العظيم صدق الله العظيم. I recited a verse from Surah Shura. In this verse of Surah Shura, Allah talks about His oneness and unity, and Allah talks about His greatness. Allah says, لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. To Him belongs what is in the heavens and what is in the earth. It means that Allah is the real owner of the entire universe and all the things present in it. Because Allah is the creator of everything in this universe, so Allah alone is the owner. And when Allah alone is the owner, so no one can challenge His authority. Everyone has to accept that Allah is the only God, Allah is the only owner and the real owner of everything. Besides that, in this passage, Allah talks about His greatness in a different way, in a very unique way. Allah says, سَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَتَّرْنَ مِنْ فَوْقِهِنْ. The heavens are close to burst, are close to rend asunder for the fear of Allah. Allah is so great that all the creations in this universe are feeling the awe of Allah. They are feeling the fear of Allah. The heavens, which look so strong and so great, Allah says that they are close to burst and they are close to tear up for the fear of Allah. But Allah holds them. Because as long as Allah wants to maintain this universe before Qiyamah, Allah is holding the heavens. And when the Qiyamah will take place, Allah will destroy the universe and the skies will also be rolled. And as Allah has mentioned that the heavens are feeling the fear of Allah here, in the other parts of the Holy Quran, Allah mentioned that other creations are also feeling the terror of Allah. Like chapter number 2, verse number 74, in Surah Baqarah, Allah talks about the rocks and Allah says that وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءُ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. That there are rocks which split and the water flows out from it. And there are rocks which move from their place and they roll down from the top of the mountains. Why it happens? So Allah says, مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. It happens because of fear of Allah. There is a physical world and there is a spiritual world. There may be different reasons for the landsliding in the physical world, but according to the spiritual world, Allah says that the reason behind these changes in the rocks is the fear of Allah. These rocks and the mountains are also busy in the worship of Allah and feeling the fear of Allah. There is another verse in the Holy Quran in which Allah says, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُصَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَصْبِيحَهُمْ. There is nothing in this universe but it celebrates the praises of its Lord, but you cannot understand its celebration. So we don't have the understanding of their language, but all the creations in this universe are busy in the celebrations of Allah's praises all the time, but we cannot understand their celebration. There is another important thing which Allah mentioned in this passage of the Holy Quran, that there are countless angels in the heavens who worship Allah. Allah says, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يُصَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. Angels celebrate the praises of their Lord. According to a hadith, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, if you will go to the heavens, you will not find any place in the heavens to stand and offer your prayer, because each and every place is fully occupied by the angels and they remain busy in the worship of Allah all the time. The Holy Quran says in chapter number 41, verse number 38, that if they are too proud, like if mankind is too proud and they don't worship Allah, so it doesn't make any difference for God. Because there are with Allah those who worship Him day and night, they don't get tired. So it refers to the angels that they worship Allah all the time and they never get tired from the worshipping of Allah. And this passage also talks about one of the very important quality of Allah, that is mercy and forgiveness. As in the end of this passage, the Holy Quran says, وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah is most merciful and Allah is very forgiving. So it is one of the unique qualities of Allah that Allah is so kind and merciful. And according to a hadith, Allah loves His creation 70 times more than a mother loves her child. And the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said in a hadith Qudsi that Allah wrote in His book before the creation of the universe, Inna rahmati wasi'at ghadabi, indeed my mercy overcomes my wrath. And there is a verse in the Holy Quran in which Allah addresses the sinful people and Allah reminds them His mercy, and Allah says, Ya ibadi alladhina asrafu ala anfusihim la taqnatu min rahmatillah. O my servants who wronged their souls, do not be hopeless from the mercy of Allah. Innahu yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Indeed, He forgives all sins. So no one can compete with Allah in being merciful and kind. We do sins for many years, but when we turn to Allah and seek His repentance, Allah welcomes us and forgives our sins. So it is also one of the unique quality of Allah which make Him the one and only God. In this passage, Muslims have many things to learn today. First of all, when we learn that everything belongs to Allah and everything is in the property of Allah, so we are also the property of Allah. We are also the slaves of Allah. The word servant is also small to explain this meaning. But we are the slaves of Allah. We are the property of Allah. And we know that a slave has no right to disobey God. So because Allah created us and Allah nurtured us, so how can we disobey God? We have no right for that. So we should become an obedient slave of Allah, from whom the master gets happy with the services of his slave. That kind of slave we need to be. Besides that, when we learn that all the creations of Allah are feeling the awe of Allah and the terror of Allah, so we should also develop the fear of Allah in our heart. The difference is that all other creations are not given the freedom of choice. Allah has set a feeling in them and they are constantly feeling the awe of Allah. And mankind is given the freedom of choice. So we use our freedom in other activities and we forget that one of the great responsibilities given to us is to worship Allah and to feel the fear of Allah. So we should also develop taqwa in us. Otherwise, it will be very embarrassing for us that on the judgment day, all other creations will come with the worship of Allah and with the good feelings for Allah, and mankind will come that they have forgotten God and they remain engrossed in the worldly things. So it should not be the condition of us on the judgment day, but we should become the fearful of Allah. And when we learned that all creations are busy in the worship of Allah and angels are busy in the worship of Allah, so we should also engage ourselves in the worship of God, at least in the prescribed manner. And that prescribed manner is the 5 times prayers and fast in the month of Ramadan. It is made obligatory on us, and there is no limit of the maximum ibadat. As much as possible for us, we should engage ourselves in the ibadat of Allah. The Holy Quran also says in Surah Zariyat, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. And I did not create the jinnat and ins, but for my worship. So the worship is one of our duties and we should perform it wholeheartedly to seek the pleasure of Allah. And in the end of the passage, there is the mention of the mercy of Allah. We should obey God, we should worship Allah, but sometimes we fail to do that. Sometimes we disobey God. Sometimes we show laziness in the worship of Allah. But when we realize our mistake, we should immediately turn to Allah and we should seek His forgiveness. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said, Kullu bani Adam khatta'un. All bani Adam, all children of Adam do mistakes. Wa khayrul khatta'ina at-tawwabun. But the best of the sinners are those who do tawbah. Allah loves those who repent to Him. The Holy Quran says, Inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. Indeed, Allah loves those who repent and Allah loves those who keep themselves pure and clean. So we should develop the habit of tawbah on regular basis. We should analyze ourselves, and wherever the shortcomings are found, we should ask Allah to forgive them. May Allah enable us to spend a pious life in a future and follow the commands of Allah in the Holy Quran. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.